A One Health approach to AMR containment, the Swedish journey.
Levels of antibiotic use and resistance in Sweden, both among humans and animals, are among the lowest in Europe and in the rest of the world. But Sweden, as it appears today, with its high living standards, social security, equality, and high trust in institutions, hasn't been around for a very long time. If we go back some 150 years, we find a completely different Sweden. In the 19th century, Sweden was an agricultural country. The life expectancy was just about 40 years, and the infant mortality was about 18%. So, how did we get here? Industrialization reached Sweden relatively late, and so did the modernization of the country. For example, Stockholm was one of the last capitals in Europe to install a sewer system. This all changed after the Second World War, when there was a great demand for raw materials and goods to rebuild Europe. Sweden, which didn't participate in the war, saw a great upswing in its industry and economy, and quickly became one of the world's richest countries. Many social reforms were made in the 50s and 60s. The public sector was developed, and a project to give all Swedes a modern home was initiated. Most of the Swedish welfare is to this day publicly financed. But is there anything in Swedish history that can explain what is so special about the way we work against antibiotic resistance? Well, Swedish working life is characterized by equality and non-hierarchical structures, both of which are preconditions for Swedish AMR work, where cross-sectoral reasoning often leads to consensus. This mentality might have its origins in the popular movements that evolved in the middle of the 19th century, which were voluntary and democratically built mass organizations. But the Swedish AMR work didn't start at a particular point in time. It all built on earlier initiatives.
Professor Otto Kars, Senior Professor Infectious Diseases and co-founder of Strama.
Already in 1959, for example, the Swedish Board of Health issued recommendations for infection and prevention control in healthcare settings. In 1986, there was a ban for antibiotics in feed for growth promotion. The first country in the world that took that decision. That created a knowledge in society about antibiotic resistance as well as the ecological and cross-dimensional aspects of it. So we can build on that. One of the major initiatives was in 1995, when something called Strama was initiated.
Strama, the strategic program against antibiotic resistance, promotes collaboration and shares best practice at all levels, locally, regionally, and nationally.
Very much of the work on antibiotic resistance is performed at the local level by the Strama groups that we have in the entire country.
Dr. Malin Grape, Head of Unit for Antibiotics and Infection Control, Public Health Agency of Sweden.
The Strama groups work directly with the healthcare practitioners. For example, they use individual and healthcare center prescription data for direct feedback and also for benchmarking.
Working with healthcare professionals is a very cost-effective way. Identifying and engaging such champions could be a very good way also in many other countries for a sustainable implementation of the National Action Plan.
The basis for the AMR work in many countries is both a National Action Plan and a National Coordination Mechanism. These should be cross-sectoral and have a One Health approach.
A drawing of three circles named animal health, human health, and environmental health. They overlap in the middle with the text One Health.
In Sweden, pharmaceutical waste is collected from the public and the healthcare sector and disposed of in centralized incinerator facilities. Wastewater is the main reservoir for pharmaceutical residues, such as antibiotics.
Anna Lövsén, Head of Unit Water and Sewer, Tekniska Verken, Linköping.
Det här är ämnen som till sin natur är svåra att bryta ner. Och våra gängse reningsmetoder i ett fullt utbyggt svenskt avloppsreningsverk är inte byggda för att ta hand om den här typen av substanser. Så vi byggde ett eget reningssteg för att ta hand om de här resterna av läkemedel.
Jenny Andersson, Poultry Farmer, Bankeberg Farm.
Det här är Bankebergs gård där vi driver ett lantbruk med kycklingar, får, en hel del skog och så lite växtodling. Det vi kallar den svenska modellen arbetades fram i mitten av 80-talet gemensamt oss i näringen, vi bönder, forskare och myndigheter, och det är ett ständigt pågående arbete. För mig som bonde innebär det att jag jobbar med mina djur förebyggande, med smittskydd, djurhälsovård, för att skapa en miljö för mina djur som innebär att jag inte behöver ge dem antibiotika.
Treatment recommendations are issued in collaboration between healthcare institutions and competent authorities. These are developed in consensus with experts representing various medical specialties. There are also patient information sheets that provide facts and advice on treatment with antibiotics. These are available in 7 languages.
Dr. Christer Norman, healthcare professional, Botkyrka vårdcentral.
Utifrån vad du berättade så tycker jag inte det är någonting som tyder på att du skulle ha lunginflammation då. Och när man sen undersöker så hittar jag ingenting konstigt heller. Det låter normalt på dina lungor, eller det finns lite små biljud, men ingenting som talar för någon lunginflammation då. Antibiotika har ingen som helst effekt på det här. Det går inte över fortare liksom.
I strongly believe that mobilizing collective efforts from countries, sectors and all levels of the society will make a difference in tackling the AMR crisis.
I'm still optimistic that we can manage this crisis. The coronavirus has led to an unprecedented knowledge about health and healthcare systems and the need for infection prevention. And I think we can build on that knowledge now to also secure access to effective antibiotics for all and make this issue everyone's business.
The 3 different health circles merge together into one circle with the text One Health, and then becomes Planet Earth, seen from space. Public Health Agency of Sweden.